Cleaning up a spill involving bloodborne pathogens or sharps is a dangerous task. Follow these steps to ensure a safe cleanup. The first step is to stop and survey the area of the spill. What are you dealing with? Is there anyone seriously injured? Is there blood or other material that might harm you? If someone is injured, he or she is your first priority. Next, find your equipment, like a biosafety spill kit. You'll need at least a lab coat, gloves, and eye protection to ensure your safety during the cleanup. If there are any sharps around the spill, pick them up with either tongs or tweezers and place them in a sharps container. Just be sure to use something that will effectively separate your skin from the sharps. If there's a lot of blood, remember that more spilled material equals more splatter, so use additional protection if needed, including disposable overalls, booties, or face shields. The next step is to clean up. Before cleaning any bloodborne pathogenic material, use your tongs or other tool to remove any sharp pieces. Then carefully cover the spill with absorbent towels, making sure to lay them out in a single layer. Spray a tuberculotal disinfectant onto the towels, making sure to use enough to soak through. Allow time for the disinfectant to work, which is usually around 10 minutes. Now, wipe up the spill from the outside in. If sharps are present, use something other than your hands. Smaller pieces may still be present even after larger pieces have been cleaned up. Repeat the above steps until no more material is left. Disinfect the spill area again and allow time for the disinfectant to work before wiping with paper towels one more time. The next step is to dispose of the waste. After the spill is cleaned up and paper towels and other waste is disposed of, spray the outside of the sharps container, the biohazard bag, and the tongs with disinfectant. Remove PPE, starting with gloves, then the lab coat, and then eye protection. If your hands become contaminated in the process, be sure to wash them before removing another piece of PPE. And lastly, wash your hands one more time after all PPE is removed.